Hi guys, I'm Shmee. Good morning to you and welcome back to the channel during a very, very exciting week for me because my new Mercedes-AMG GTR has arrived, as you might have seen from the big reveal video. But you joined me today at Mercedes-Benz Brentford a week earlier to get the preparations started to pick up the car, sign everything, officially collect it, and take it over to Topaz to start the process to protect the beast. Now, you might be wondering why we're going to Topaz for a detail and paint protection film when I said that I'd ordered it in black to vinyl wrap the car. Well, let me be honest, I saw pictures of it, and decided it looks so good and so stealthy in black that I'm gonna keep it that way for at least the short term, which means today we're gonna take that flat black paintwork, take it over to Topaz, perfect it, protect it, and then that has the double advantage that if in the future I choose to vinyl wrap it, which I'm probably going to do, it adds an extra layer of protection underneath to keep this car looking good, because I'm gonna do a lot of miles in it. This car is gonna go absolutely everywhere. Anyway, it's sitting in the showroom behind me. I've driven over today in the GT8, another of the SHMEE plated cars, but it sat right there. I can see the headlights on, blinking inside the window. We'll head in. This is officially collection day. I mean, you've already seen the car by this point, probably in the big reveal, which I hope was a rather special video. But we're gonna take it out of the showroom, take it over to the transporter over the other side, load it up, and head over to Topaz. And the reason for that is to not drive it on the road, not risk getting it chipped. So let's head inside, head straight over to the car in here in the handover bay, where you have the distinct silhouette of the AMG GTR. But it's time to pull the cover off. Here we go, the slow and painful teasing reveal of the AMG GTR. And just look at the front of this car. It is so wide and menacing. The Panamericana grille, I'll run you quickly over some of the specification that I've chosen for the car, but the black with the yellow highlights, you can see the embroidery, the seat belts, the brake calipers, it's got the optional lightweight wheels on it. We've got the carbon fiber exterior packs, so the mirrors, the rear wing, naturally, the beast of the green hell has to have the wing, the carbon fiber roof, but it's just menacing and stealthy. And if you're wondering, 67 by the way, 67 is the current registration series in the United Kingdom, but also AMG was founded in 1967, so it could not be more perfect. AMG GTR, wow, this car. Oh, it's locked, I can't jump in yet to show you that in a moment, but super, super cool. Okay, unlock. Let's have a look in here, where it's all about the bucket seats. I think a car like this has to have them. Then I've got the Dynamica interior, the Alcantara, the yellow stitching, the optional yellow seat belts, the satin carbon fiber. And there we've got our traction control dial, our 9-stage traction control, Alcantara steering wheel. This is going to be a good car for some mega trips. But I think the purpose of today is to get it out on the road over to Topaz. So let's fire it up and take it out. Into life, 4-litre bi-turbo V8, 585 horsepower, and that's what made the 7-minute 11-second Nürburgring time. Rear wheel steer as well, by the way, that's pretty neat. So let's head out, see the car emerging outside for the first time ever as my car. It's so freaking cool. Just absolute menace. And being London, we have to have a police siren, naturally. Look at this thing. Look how wide that front is. Better get out of the way. The bubbles. Savagery. Other specification option I didn't mention, which is the assistance pack at the front, the technology, so radar, cruise control, and the pre-safe protection safety stuff, so it breaks you if you're going to accidentally hit anything. But you just look at it here. Oh, this is good. That side profile is so cool, a massive long bonnet, the rearward canopy, and then the wing at the back. Loaded up, ready to head off. I'm gonna jump in the GT8 and drive over to Now, it's kind of strange for me because at this point, I have not driven my AMG GTR. Instead, I will jump in here, which has 4,000 miles now on the clock. Good innings. The GTR will do plenty more than that. We start, we open the exhaust valve, because everybody likes a little bit of noise. This car is ridiculous. So let's head over to Topaz and get the process started. Jump ahead and you join me at Topaz, where the trailer is just arriving now. And this is Topaz's own trailer that they can use to go and pick up cars, which just saves you from that pesky, inevitable stone chip that you can get on the way home from the dealer or on the way to bringing a car here. So I parked up the GT8 in some pretty nice company, the two GT3s. Mine is coming very soon. And in the corner, a gorgeous Ferrari 812 Superfast, the blue Tour de France blue with the red accents on the calipers and the trim inside. That thing is stunning. But we're going to come over here, we're going to unload the car, take it in, but we're going to do this video in a slightly different way to normal, because I'm going to meet up with Nabil, one of the co-founders of Topaz, and he's going to take you through this process as a man who knows a little bit more than I do. He started detailing cars, now he's running Topaz, which has become a seriously impressive outfit. They've done a number of my cars before, but let's get the GTR out, see it next to the GT8, and then head inside. It is always an exciting moment to see a trailer cover open, even if you've just been with the car 20-25 minutes before. But we'll fire it up, reverse it back, and go from there. That's such a rumbly grumble, titanium exhaust. And the shutter is magically open into Topaz. Hey, there's another GTR. And there's Nabil. How are you? Nice to see you.
Oh my God, I heard thunder. I thought I had to come out.
It's good, right?
Oh my God. This is my spec.
Yeah?
Solid black. Oh my God. I love the way this thing looks. I think I'm gonna have to do the reporting after this. I need to drool over the car a little bit.
Okay, I'll leave you to it. We'll see the car coming off for now. Now that is cool. The two front-engined V8 beasts. But these two cars are complete polar opposites, because you've got the naturally aspirated manual, very old school. Then you've got the super modern twin turbocharged, paddle shift gearbox, craziness of the GTR. We're in.
Okay, I'm done drooling. I'm sorry about that.
No worries. I don't blame you. I am loving it like this. Well, as you know, we were originally going to wrap it in a different color. Yeah. Now we're keeping it like this. That's why it's here.
It looks amazing. Anyway.
What are we doing?
Let's go through it. First stage was to get the car here. That's been done.
Success.
Second stage is to get the car over to the wash bay so that we can decontaminate it mechanically and chemically. I'll go through about that a bit later on. Stage after that, we're going to inspect it to make sure that the paint has no impurities or imperfections from the factory. After that, we're going to get the car over to the detailing bay, get the car paint corrected, bring it over here, put PPF on it, ship it back to you.
And then it'll be ready to drive. Well, I am very much looking forward to this.
In a nutshell.
That's in a nutshell. There'll be a bigger explanation of this and why we do this as well.
Yeah,
because that's
sure.
The biggest question always on a brand new car. A little bit more to explain about that. Anyway, I'm going to leave it in your trusty hands.
Let's do it.
I look forward to seeing the car when it's finished.
Yeah.
Camera, over to you.
Let's do it. You're with me, guys. Fast forward some time and now the car is ready to go to the wash bay, which is great news because then we can go and get it decontaminated and get it prepped, ready for some paint correction. I already had a quick glance over the car. There's a couple of defects that need to be sorted out, but it's all regular stuff that comes from factory. So let's go over there and get it checked out. So the process of the washing is now well underway. So the reason why we do this, especially to a new car, is just to make sure that it's absolutely perfectly clean before we start to do any paint correction. Because if there's any particles within that within get stuck within the pad and the surface of the paint, it's gonna cause pigtails, which are small little tiny scratches, which is gonna cause an issue. So this is what we're doing right now, giving it a really good deep clean, and then we're gonna go over to the inspection bay. What we're gonna do now is chemically decontaminate the paintwork. Now, some of you may be asking, why do you need to decontaminate paintwork when it's brand new? The reason being is that it could be left outside for any time and then some fallout would go onto the paintwork and be embedded into the clear coat. So it's of vital importance that we remove all that before we continue to the next stage. As anything, it's always in the preparation. Preparation is key, doing anything to make sure that's perfect. So we're gonna go over to the decontamination process now, which, do you know what? I'll give you some more details about it. Let's go into a bit more depth about decontamination and paintwork. So, this is what you have. This is your construction of your paint. You have your actual body panel, your primer, your colour, base coat, and your clear coat, which is obviously the lacquer. Now, what we do in terms of detailing and paint protection film, we try to protect the clear coat, which is this upmost surface area of the paintwork. Now, when you have different defects and different problems with the paintwork, usually you have two issues, either above the surface contaminants or below the surface contaminants. Now, above the surface contaminants are things like overspray, things like brake dust, rail dust. Again, that's due to industrial pollution, etc. You get the same thing there. Now, you can see that's all above the surface. When these items are above the surface, chemical decontamination and mechanical decontamination can remove these issues. Now, with things that are like scratches that are within the clear coat layer and obviously swirl marks, these are issues that we have to remove through paint correction. So even on a new car, you may have some light marring and light swirl marks. As I showed you before, you have also holograms, which are basically thousands of these swirl marks, but in the same pattern. All these can be removed with a bit of paint correction. So this is why I thought I'd show you a bit more of a good idea to understand what we do in terms of paint work. Hope that helped. The car is now in our inspection bay, so we're going to be inspecting this car and also paint correcting it in this area. Now, the reason why we want to inspect it thoroughly is to make sure that we know what we're working with, because there's so many ranges of compounds, polishes, abrasives, and there's also a lot of ranges of machines. You've got dual action machines, rotary machines, and even the dual action machines have different size of throws. So it's a whirlwind of different products that you can use. The most important thing is ascertaining what you have, what are your problems that you have with the car, with the paintwork, with the finish, and then you then can then select your itinerary. We've been doing this for a long, long time, so we know exactly just by looking at the paint and having a quick look over the defects, and we go, yep, you can use this product, this product, this product, this product, and that will get the exact result we're looking for. Obviously, each person has a different level of what they expect the result to be. With us, it's very high because of that's who we are, that's what we do. So let's get in there and I'll show you exactly what I'm talking about when I'm talking about defects. So this is a really good example that I found here of what holograms look like. As you can see, there is essentially thousands and thousands and thousands of scratches that are been induced in the paintwork by heat and an abrasive product being circulated around, obviously, a machine. As well as loads of scratches you get in the paintwork, you also get to see that there's some horizontal lines. These are what you would call holograms. Now, the reason why they're called holograms is because they actually look like a hologram effect, like sort of ghosts in your paintwork. Perfect time for Halloween. Now, a reason for this happening is purely down to the incorrect machine pattern compound combination being used on this type of paintwork. So we got to the stage now where we're masking up the areas that we don't want to get damaged. And the reason why we do that is a prime example. If you have a look around the car, you may get to see some telltale signs where previous works were done on the vehicle, even on production line or dealer work, that has potentially made the area turn white. And that's because it's pure friction onto the actual area. So we make sure we cover all the areas that can potentially get damaged in order for that not to happen. At the same time, we're gonna go in and rectify all those rubber seals that have turned white. And by way of magic, the car is now done. So the car is rinsed now, it's actually just behind me. It's about to go into our bay here, where you see the lighting is all different in aspects, so you get a huge amount of lighting in that area. And we're gonna start applying our paint protection film, so let's see how it goes. Just to show you, the way that we design our patterns is actually all pre-cut. If you see right at the area there is the corner piece, so that shows you exactly where it needs to go, and then the two areas here and here actually wrap around the edges. So we try to make sure that every single area of the paint has actually been covered, but the only thing you got to remember is with regards to wrapping edges, a lot of people try to say, oh, we can wrap every single edge and try to compare it to vinyl wrapping. It's not the same thing, because with vinyl wrapping, it's obviously dry, it can go around the corners, and the actual adhesive is also very different. With paint protection film, you have to have a very different approach. So when you're trying to wrap around the edges, you got to think of two things. First of all, you have to get the right protection. Of course, that's, you want to get the most protection. That's the whole point about paint protection film. But at the same time, you don't want that edge to be lifting. And if that edge, if the edge has actually been painted in a rough surface, or if it's a matte surface, it will not adhere. So that means we're going to put the wrap around, and after about 2-3 weeks, a month at max, it's going to come up again, and then the customer is going to be complaining. So it's a fine balance, and because we've done so many cars and so many different aspects and so many different contours and convex curves, we know what we're doing in terms of that aspect. And don't be fooled if someone says to you, oh, I can wrap that, and they can wrap that. And if they do, more than likely they're going to wrap it, and after a while it's going to come back up again. Just be careful of that. After we've actually done this stage, we then have different quality control stages. So obviously Chubba now is going to make sure that the quality is perfect to what he's done. Then we're going to have someone else to come over, a specific individual, and have a look at the quality of the standard of the work that he's produced. And then once that's done, it then gets a final sign off by the workshop manager as well. So quite a few stages, and obviously the car gets checked periodically throughout the detailing process also. It's a lot of processes, a lot of quality control, but that's what it's all about. You gotta have the quality control correct. Okay everyone, good morning. It's now D-Day, the day that we're gonna be handing over the car to Tim. We're going through the last stages of the process at the moment. It's QC, tidy up, and making sure if there's anything that needs to be rectified, gets rectified right now. This is one of the key stages that makes us different to everyone else, is that we have a lot of eyes looking at the car to make sure that every single part of the job is completed correctly. So really looking forward to Tim seeing it. It's gonna be, I think Tim's coming in the next 15 minutes. And then so the next video will be with him. Let's see what he thinks.
And we're back.
Car is looking good.
Ta-da.
Yeah,
it's looking
awesome.
What do you think?
Well, just the final things now, but front end paint protection, I'm just coming in closely. I know that black is a very hard color to work on, but.
Yeah, yeah, especially solid black. It's the most difficult color to be working on in terms of paint
protection. Any mark show through.
Yeah, definitely, definitely.
So what have we filmed? Because I haven't actually seen your video clips yet.
So basically it's the full front, the side tills have been done, the wing mirrors were done, and obviously the headlights were also done.
Vulnerable parts.
Yeah, exactly. We've also, we've wrapped around wherever possible all the edges to make sure that it's a seamless install. And yeah, it just looks, I'm so happy with the final result. It looks fantastic.
Tell me about it. I'm just walking around it thinking, I never would have thought that this would be, say, my spec.
Yeah.
But I'm looking at it and it looks mega.
Yeah, it's a bit tame for you, Tim.
it's the stealthy beast.
Yeah.
No, really, but
it looks
cool.
Really good. And there was a couple of impurities and defects that come from factory. That was all rectified and made perfect as well. But that's all gone through with the video anyway, so.
Wonderful. Well, I look forward to watching those clips. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
For the moment, we will take the car back out. It's going to be loaded back into the truck.
Yes.
Get back to the dealer.
Yeah.
So official handover happens with it having never driven a mile on the road.
That's the right way of doing it. Yeah.
And I'm quite excited now to drive it. Thank you.
Cool. Yeah. Let me know what it drives like. I'm excited.
Yeah, sure. Well, you can drive it at some point.
I will do. Everywhere. All the time.
They know it now.
It's going to be me driving, not Tim anymore. It's going to be me in that car.
maybe not so sure. Anyway, thank you.
You're welcome. You're welcome.
There we have it then. That is this part of the road, I suppose, to the AMG GTR. But by now, the collection video is already out there. So if you haven't checked it out, where the car is going now for the day that it has in store is really pretty epic. It looks so, so good. And that was a Ferrari V12 noise we just heard starting up. But loaded back into Topaz's trailer to be taken back to the Mercedes-Benz dealer ahead of the activities that are out there on YouTube. Anyway, a big thanks goes to Nabil for taking the reins on this video. I hope he's done a nice job, as good a job as on the car itself. Anyway, I'll wrap this one up for there. This is a very, very exciting time. This car is going to be mega, and I can't wait for what it's going to be doing, especially in this look. It just looks so mean, so menacing, so crazy. I'm very excited for the drives ahead. So thank you everyone for watching. Thank you for your support, without which this wouldn't be possible. Really, really appreciate it. And I'll catch up with you guys again very soon. Cheers.